everyone. Very good morning. This is Vrushali Kalwale from Kernagar Municipal English Secondary School. And I'm here, your science teacher. And today, we are going to see the chapter number 2, and specifically the page number 16. And the topic is energy from different food components. Okay. Before we start with our today's topic, the subtopic, I would like to give you the reminder and recall for the things which have you already done in this chapter, like the various metabolic pathways. Then what are the different life processes? Then what are the how these life processes, what are the different things which are working in our body, requires some kind of specific way, you know, through which we can generate the energies. Okay, so that we have seen in different metabolic pathways like glycolysis and all. Okay, so today we have to see what are the different sources, okay, of energy. Okay, so let us start with this. So source of energy is food. Yes, so why do we need food? This is my first question to all of you. Let us find out answer for this. First, we will see the definition for the food. Any nutritious substance that people or animal eat or drink, or that plants absorb in order to maintain the life and growth, is called food. It is also known as nutrients. For the survival, for your growth and development, what we required, what we take in, even though plants, animals, that is called as a food. This is a basic definition for the food. Then why do we need food? My first question. There are three things. There are three basic broader things. First, we need energy. Second, it is responsible for the growth as well as it keeps you healthy. Like energy, where we require energy? Muscle movements, body temperature, which is measured in kilojoules. Okay, one example is also given over there. That is, apple has 224 kilojoules of energy. So that is 224 thousands of joules. Okay. Then growth, for material for cell growth and replacing the old cells, okay, for your maintenance of your body and keeping you healthy, that is to keep cells and organs functioning properly. Okay, we are alive, it is only because we are having that all our organs and functions are working properly. Okay, we'll see the classification of food. There are various types of food, like we have energy supplying food, body building foods, and repairing and maintenance food. Okay, these are the three things, three types of foods we require. Energy supply, who supplies? Cereals, sugars, roots, tubers, fats and oils. Then body building foods are like milk, meat, poultry, eggs, fish, pulses and groundnuts. Repairing and maintenance food is like vegetables, fruits and milk. These are the repairing one. See, all of you in between, you can take the screenshots. Okay, it will be helpful for you to for the quick revision later on. So here the one word is given, tubers. Tubers in energy supplying food. The tubers is nothing but the storage of the nutrients. Okay, which is involved in the asexual reproduction. That means it's present in plant. It is a plant part. Which stores all the required nutrients of that particular plant, and it involves in the asexual reproduction. So this is all about the tubers. Now next, five main food groups. Okay, fruits and vegetables is the first one. Second one is a meat, fish and alternatives. Third one is food containing fat and foods containing sugar. The fourth group is a milk and dairy products, and the fifth one is a bread, other cereals and potatoes. So these are the some food groups that we have. Means whatever we have our diet, it comes from all these five groups. So here we are starting with our actual topic for the day, that is energy from different food components at page number 16, chapter number 2. So here we have carbohydrates, proteins, then lipids and vitamins. For a day, we are going to see only three components, that is carbohydrates, proteins and lipids. So let us start with what is carbohydrate. It defines as, these are the major source of energy from our diet, composed of elements, carbon, hydrogen, and oxygen, also called saccharides. The saccharide word itself tells you it's a sugar. So the carbohydrates are nothing but the sugar. Why do we require then carbohydrates? Its importance is, first, the most abundant biomolecules on earth, is most abundant, easily available, then produced by the conversion of more than 100 billion metric tons of carbon dioxide and water in photosynthesis. So who utilizes this for the photosynthesis? Plant. And plants are abundant, right? On earth, it is easily available. So all these resources are there. So that's why carbohydrate is also present in abundance. Third one, a major dietary staple, and its oxidation is central in energy building pathway in living cell. Okay, please connect this point number three with what you have learned in the first half of this chapter, where you have discussed about the various cycles for the energy building pathways. Okay, then structural and protective elements in the cell walls of bacteria and plants and in the connective tissues of animals. Connective tissue example is blood. Okay, so we have seen the tissues also, the different types of tissues in standard 9. Then fifth one is a lubricate the skeletal joints and participate in recognition and adhesion between cells as a glycoconjugates. It acts as an adhesive, adhesion attached, okay, to get it fixed. So lubricate skeletal joints and participate is recognition and adhesion. So it helps in joining and conjugating. So that is glycoconjugate. Next, classification of carbohydrates. Carbohydrates are classified according to the number of subunits that makes them up. Like three types we have. One is a monosaccharide, only one. Oligosaccharide, there are many. And poly is again a polymer. So we have disaccharide, trisaccharide, and tetrasaccharide. Saccharides is again a sugar. Di means two, tri means three, and tetra means four. So these are about the general idea about the carbohydrates types. Then what are the sources? Most carbs come from plants. If you just connect with the previous slide that you have seen, the lots of carbohydrate and carbon dioxide and water, it is involved in photosynthesis and we get the abundance of carbohydrates on the earth. Okay, so there, that's why the first statement is most carbs come from plants. Again, we have three types for the sources again, like starches, which are complex carbs, sugars, which are simple carbs, and cellulose, which is non-digestible fiber. So starches, again, bread, cereal, potatoes, we have already discussed the sources. In sugar, we get a white bread, pancakes, muffins, pastries, these are the simple sugars. And then we have simple carbs. Then we have cellulose, that is non-digestible fiber. This is bran, whole grain food, the raw vegetables, fruits, especially with the seeds and skin. These are non-digestible, okay? Nuts and seeds and popcorn. So some of the sources. Next, role of carbohydrates. What they do in our body? As a major energy source for living organisms. Second, as a means of transporting the energy. Okay, first they available as a source. Secondly, transporting the energy like sucrose in plant tissues. Then third one, we have as a structural material like cellulose in plants, chitin in insects, building blocks of nucleotides. You have learned this, okay? In the structure of DNA, we have sugar molecule, like sugars we have. So here the carbohydrates plays an important role. In purines and pyrimidines, they act as a precursors. Okay, so as a precursor for the other biomolecules like purines and pyrimidines. Now, what do you mean by the precursors? Precursor, that means they are attached before. That is called as a precursor. So, just role of carbohydrates is a major energy source. Second is means of transporting the energy. Fourth is a structural material like we have DNA molecule and precursors of the other biomolecules like purines and pyrimidines. Then, role of carbohydrate in nutrition. If you don't have enough of carbohydrates, then some of the deficiencies you can observe. And if you take a lot of carbohydrates, then you can see some of the consequences because of the excessive consumption of carbohydrates. carbs. First one, we'll see about the deficiencies. Ketosis, the excessive breakdown of protein, fatigue and decreased energy level and reduce the fiber intake. Okay, so it's a source of energy, it's a main source of energy, so definitely you will feel fatigue and as well as the energy level will decrease down. If you take much of these carbohydrates, what will happen to you? The types like type 2 diabetes, that is dental caries and obesity, that is too much of weight gain, that is called as obesity. Dental caries, that means dental, you know, you will be having dental issues. And diabetes too, that is just because of the diet, okay, the imbalanced diet like excessive consumption. Like normal person, high carb meal, sugars are broken down and absorbed into the bloodstream, okay, for the normal one. When there is too much of sugar, then insulin is released from the pancreas and moves out excess glucose from blood. It takes out excess glucose from the blood because it is not required in blood. So then insulin has to work on it, okay. Next, how the digestion of the carbohydrate looks like. See, these carbohydrates molecules, like starch molecule we have, we take the source as in the form of starch. When it is digested, that you can see on the arrow, that is digested, and then you get the simpler forms of sugar molecules. Next. Yes, digestion of carbohydrates at your body level. Okay, in mouth, what happens? Stomach, small intestine, and intestinal linings. What happens? First, at mouth. Dietary carbohydrates, whatever we take in, we have an enzyme in our saliva, that is salivary alpha amylase. Then we have polysaccharide, it's converted into polysaccharides, dextrins, sucrose, lactose and maltose. These are the simpler sugars, okay, polysaccharides. Then from this, we go to small intestine. So pancreatic alpha amylase is another enzyme which is helps in the digestion of the carbohydrates. At the small intestine level, what we get? The monosaccharide, glucose, galactose and fructose. Okay, the another types of sugar. And at intestinal linings, we get the monosaccharide, the simpler sugars. In our bloodstream, it is absorbed. And it is an active transportation happens over there. And we get the actual energy what we have eaten. Okay, as a source, from the source of carbohydrate. Next. Where enzymes are produced, these are some of the enzymes I have mentioned here. They are produced in salivary glands, stomach, stomach and pancreas. Again, see, you can see the salivary glands, then stomach, pancreas and the small intestine. So the whole digestion of the carbohydrates is takes place at these levels, and some of the enzymes I have listed here. You can take a screenshot for your extra information. Okay, can we move ahead? Metabolic pathway. Glycolysis is solving process glucose into the ATP and pyruvate. Again, you have seen this glycolysis before. Glycogenesis is the process of formation of the glycogen from glucose. Yes, this is important here that we need to understand. Like glycogen, it is what do you mean by the glycogen? It is a form of energy which is stored in animals. Okay, it is stored in liver. And it is in the form of polysaccharides. Poly, that means polymer of sugars. Okay, a long chain, that is polysaccharides. You have to remember this. The glycogen, it is stored form of sugar and it is stored in animals. Okay, in the form of polysaccharide. And where it is stored, it is in liver. Then glycogenolysis is glycogen into glucose solving process. Okay, glycogenesis is the process of glucose or glycogen formation of simple organic compound. As you have seen in the previous slide, that at the end stages, like, you know, at the lining of the intestine, we get the monosaccharide. There are the simpler sugars from the very much complex carb what we have taken. Here, one more thing. We have buccal cavity. There we have starch gets converted into maltose with the help of salivary amylase. Then at the small at stomach, no carbohydrate digestion takes place. The much of it is taken into the small intestine, and we have seen how it is gets converted from one product, you know, to the simpler ones. And at the end product, you can see the glucose and fructose we get it. So please take a screenshot of this. It will help you to remember how the digestion takes place. Next. Now, health benefits of carbohydrate. Energy for body, helps to sleep better, helps to prevent the diseases, definitely. Useful to control the weight, that helps to keep memory sharp. Then uplifts your moods, provides fiber to the body, then prevents blood clots, then improves the digestive system, and the best nutrients for athletes. This is also a very compact and it is easy to remember in a pictorial form. You can take it. Then deficiency due to carbohydrates. Carbohydrates are the chief source of energy for the body. The energy produced by the carbohydrates are used up by our body to perform various tasks. Deficiency of this sufficient carbohydrate leads to body weakness and the loss of stamina. We have seen this. Now, malnutrition of carbohydrates, low body weight, accumulation of the large amount of ketone bodies in the body. Now, what is ketones? Okay, ketone bodies are the low glucose, you know, and it contains the ketones are the water soluble molecule which is produced by the liver. When it happens, these ketones or the ketones, they don't have a proper source of energy. Then, the stored lipids, okay, these water soluble molecules which are given up by the liver. And because of that, it is given up by the liver and it gives, and just to maintain the conditions in our body, the homeostasis, the liver gives out the material which is required, and that is ketone bodies, and that situation, that condition is called as a ketosis. Okay, that physiological condition is called as a ketosis. Then, overconsumption, increased dental caries, cause obesity, large amounts of sugar, like gastric ulcer, it may happen, depressed appetite, soft drinks, and then increase the blood triglycerides, lead to heart diseases. Yes, here the additional point is about triglycerides. Now, what are these triglycerides? These are the extra calories, okay, which is not required by our body. It gets saturated and we face the problems like heart diseases. Now, good versus bad carbs. These are some of the examples for the good carbs, like non-starchy vegetables, okay, starchy vegetables, then we have fruits and greens, green vegetables, whereas for the bad, soda, white pasta, white rice, sugar, then sugary cereals. So you can see what we actually consume. So for that, I have made this chart over here. The starchy ways, then these are some of the smart sources that one should engage in your diet, okay? Starchy ways, legumes, then the whole grains, fruits, okay? Like we have potatoes, pumpkin, sweet potatoes in starchy, it gives you abundant of starch. Legumes like beans, chickpeas, lentils, okay? You can see the many of the examples from our day-to-day life also I have listed over here, and some of the additional and new examples you can see. For the fruits, we have apples, apricots, bananas, figs, okay, grapes, guavas, kiwi fruit, lemons and limes, mangoes, melons, so many are there, okay? All these are rich and smart sources of carbohydrates. Now, our second component is protein. Energy from different components like proteins. Let us understand what is protein. Proteins are the most abundant organic molecules of the living system. They constitute about 50% of the cellular dry weight. They constitute the fundamental basis of structure and function of life. In 1839, Dutch chemist, the G.J. Mulder, was first to describe about protein. The term protein is derived from a Greek word proteos, meaning first place. The proteins are nitrogenous macromolecules that are composed of many amino acids. Okay, for carbohydrates, we have seen the saccharides, there are the sugar. Okay, here what we have, the amino acid, okay, from which we get the protein, and they are nitrogenous macromolecules, okay, the major molecule in nitrogenous in nature. Protein structure prediction. That is, what is protein? Proteins are the large molecules consisting of amino acids which our bodies and these cells in our bodies need to function properly. Okay, for that we require. So, first one is what? For the proper function. Second is our body structures, functions, the regulations of the body cell, tissues and organs cannot exist without proteins. Please remember, each and every cell, okay, then the group of cell that is tissues, and again tissue forms the organ and organ system. The entire body is nothing without the proteins. Our muscles like skin, bones and many other parts of the body contain significant amounts of proteins. Okay, so how much protein? Protein accounts for 20% of the total body weight. Whatever our body weight is there, the 20% will be is your protein. Okay, importance of protein. Proteins form the building units of all body cells. Yes. Second one is almost all enzymes are protein in nature. Many hormones are present, are protein in nature, as insulin and thyroxin. We have heard this name. Certain biological compounds necessary for maintenance of life as a hemoglobin, myoglobin, etc. are protein substances. Immunoglobulins, globulins that are called as antibodies present in the body are protein in nature, and osmotic pressure of plasma proteins is necessary for exchange of fluids between the blood and interstitial fluid. Interstitial fluid, that means the fluid which is present between the cells, that is interstitial fluid. Okay, then I would like to give you some idea about it. Like hemoglobin, all of you know, but what is myoglobin? Okay, so the myoglobin is it's an iron and oxygen binding protein found in the skeletal muscles tissue of the vertebrates. It is almost present in all the mammals. Okay, so that is what it is bound to, iron and oxygen. And it is a skeletal muscle tissue. It is present where? It is found in skeletal muscle tissue. So, myoglobin. Okay. So, this is about the importance of the proteins. Now, two types of proteins we have. Fibrous protein and globular proteins. Fibrous protein we have is about the rope-like structural proteins form the shape of the cells and the tissues. Whatever is present in our tissues. Okay. The collagen, the most abundant protein of the vertebrates. Example is what? Collagen is one of the most abundantly found protein. Globular protein is have specific shape for their function. Enzymes and antibodies. Okay, there is lock and key mechanism exist in the globular protein, because that's why they have a proper shape to the antigen antibody. Okay, so just to fit into that, they have a specific shapes. Now, what is the biological function of the protein? First, they act as a catalytic function. As I told you about the enzymes, nearly all chemical reactions in biological system are catalyzed by the specific enzymes. Okay, catalyst means that to speed up the reaction, to speed up to carry out that reaction properly. Okay, it helps in conducting that chemical reaction. So that is all about the enzymes. Okay, it acts as a catalyst. Second one, it acts as a transport and storage. It is important in what? The transport and storage. That is hemoglobin. Hemoglobin transport the oxygen in the blood. Myoglobin, just I told you, it carries and stores the oxygen in the muscle. Albumin, which transports the free fatty acid in the blood. We will see that in lipids, what are the fatty acids. And transferrin is one of the example which transports the ion in blood. Okay, then coordinated motion. Actin and myosin are contractile proteins in muscle. These two types of proteins are present in your muscle. That's why we can just coordinate ourselves. Okay, our muscles are our appendages. Understood? So this is all about it, the functions of the protein. First is catalytic transport and third one is coordinated motion. We'll continue with this. The fourth one is a structural and mechanical support, collagen. Okay, This is most abundant, which is found in vertebrates. This is fibrous protein in the skin and bone. You can find out this collagen. Then fifth one is a defense function, clotting factor, which prevents the loss of blood. Immunoglobulin, which protects against the infection. As I told you, these are the antibodies. So functional level per, it is structural and mechanical stuff. Fifth one is defense. Okay. The sixth one is acts as a generation and transmission of the nerve impulses, receptors, protein, just in related to our nervous system. And seventh one is a control of the growth and differentiation. That means what? The activities of the different cells are coordinated by hormones. Many hormones are polypeptides and proteins, such as insulin and thyroid stimulating hormone. Okay, here we have seen the two names like insulin and thyroid stimulating hormone. Okay, so control of growth and differentiation. We'll see about the digestion of proteins. Dietary proteins, as it is taken, okay, mouth level, then stomach, it is HCl and pepsin is present. So it is denatured and partially hydrolyzed protein, means the structure gets altered. So denatured, if we talk about what do you mean by the denatured, the proteins and nucleic acid lose their structure. The actual structure in which they are existing in their source form, they get denatured because of, I mean, their structure changes because of the HCl and pepsin which is present in the stomach. Okay, then from stomach to the small intestine, then trypsin, then we have a chymotrypsin, aminopeptase, then carboxypeptase, okay. And we get the small peptides, we get the small amino acid from that complex protein. As we know, the proteins are made up of amino acids, right? And at the intestinal lining, where the actual absorption happens, okay, the actual transport happens where the amino acids in the bloodstream. And the required amino acid is, you can find in a bloodstream. So that way, the digestion of the protein takes place. Here, same way I have mentioned it, but in a different form. You can take a screenshot. Here at the organ level also you can see how these various types of enzymes acts on the protein, and at the end we get the amino acid, which is absorbed into the small intestine, and it is into the intestinal lining, sorry. Yeah. Metabolic pathway. Here you can see these oval shaped, and the word it is written some amino acids, some amino acids, some amino acids. Yes. So during this glycolysis, whatever the other stages that you can see over here, that is citric acid cycle, we get the amino acid, acetyl coenzyme, from that some of the ketone bodies. Just now I told you what are the ketone bodies, some of the fatty acids, then some of the amino acids are also produced at the acetyl coenzyme level. Okay, and at pyruvate also, you can say pyruvate is also getting from this some of the amino acids. So, at these are the different metabolic pathway where you can see the protein involved, or you can say the some of the amino acids are involved in these cycles. Then, health benefits of proteins. Muscle development, help with bone metabolism, control the sugar levels, slow down the aging process, then prevent the hair damage, help maintain an ideal weight, then prevent the heart-related diseases, then improve the immune system, help in hormone balance, and makes skin healthy. Okay, all your metabolism, definitely it covers everything, because cell, tissues, organs are nothing without the proteins. So that's why we have lots of benefits we can maintain our body. Yeah. Now, symptoms for the deficiency and as well as the protein excess. Loss of muscle, muscle tone, confusion, slow wound healing, irritability, food retention, fluid retention, then food cravings, then too acid or alkaline, then fatigue, muscle, weaknesses. We have thin hair, weak nails, weight loss, so many deficiencies. My God, too much. Then if we go take an axis of it, then acidosis and dehydration, constipation, then putrefaction in the gut if the stomach acid is low, then the loss of bone if vitamin D and calcium are low, and if there is a lot of proteins, then again loss of bones, then musculoskeletal issues, okay, kidney dysfunctioning because it has to filter a lot of protein. Okay, that creates a pressure on the kidneys, and we find the dysfunctioning of the kidney. Then ammonia, nitrogen in the blood because too much of amino acid is released. Okay, then food that contains protein. Both plants and animal food contains protein. Foods that provide all the essential amino acids are called complete proteins. Animal food such as meat, fish, poultry, eggs, and dairy products are all high quality proteins. Foods that do not provide a good balance of all the essential amino acids are called as an incomplete protein. So complete protein and incomplete protein. If you don't get enough of protein source, then that is incomplete. Plant products contain lower quality proteins. Most of the fruits and vegetables are poor source of protein, but they are the good source of carbohydrates. We have seen that. Biological importance of protein. Like how carbohydrate is biologically important, like that we have to see about the proteins important. Plasma membrane protein, that like channels, carrier, pump protein regulate the transfer of many of the substances across the cell membrane. Interstitial fluid, as you have remember. Then all receptors are protein in nature. All the enzymes, protein, all the antibodies, hormones, that we have discussed that in detail before. Then again, some proteins are protective. Okay, this is some of the additional points. Like keratin, skin, hair, nail, that make the skin resistant to chemical. Some of the proteins are supportive, like collagen. Hemoglobin, that carries the oxygen. Actin, myosin, for your contractile protein found in your muscle cells, responsible for the muscular contraction. And amino acids are converted to other nitrogenous substances of a great physiological importance, like creatine, histamine, hem, purines, and pyrimidines. Purines, pyrimidines, you have seen. But what is creatine and what is histamine? Okay, the histamine is an organic nitrogenous compound. Okay, which is a local immune response. It gives you local immune response. It involves in a giving out the immune response. That means, for example, it is one of the mediator. If you have the itching, that is the reaction which is given up by the body to particular infection. Okay, so here histamine is involved. Then creatine is another energy currency of the cell. It is one of the protein which is a chemical compound, okay, that is creatine. Most of the bodybuilders, they use this. Next, energy from the food components, lipids, and this is the last one for the day, the third component that we are seeing. We'll see the definition. Lipids may be regarded as organic substances, relatively insoluble in water, soluble in organic solvents, actually or potentially related to fatty acids and utilized by the living cells. They are potentially related to what? The fatty acids. Okay, this word is important, the fatty acids, and they are the organic substances. Insoluble in water, but soluble in organic solvents. Now, the question arises, what are the organic solvents? Okay, the organic solvents are nothing but the carbon-based substances. Okay, these are the carbon-based substances. Organic means what? Which contains the carbon. Dissolving one or more substances. That means they can just dissolve the components in them because they have a carbon content in it. Okay, so some insoluble in water and soluble in organic solvents. Okay, now we'll see its structure. Fats, oils, and waxes, these are the sources from which we get the lipids. They provide the energy for the cell structure and insulation. Its main function is what? The insulation, the protection that gives us cell structure. Okay. Like lipid and proteins compose the cell membrane. Okay, along with the protein. We have seen how the protein helps in maintaining the cell membrane structure. Like that, lipids are coordinating with the proteins. Okay, and that the cell membrane exists properly. Then cholesterol gives the cell membrane flexibility. Okay, not only the maintaining the structure, but the flexibility like absorbing osmosis. Okay, all these things are happening at the cellular level. For carrying out the various chemical reactions where it gives us the cell membrane proper flexibility. Lipid structure, we have two parts. One is head, another one is a tail. Head, we have glycerols, okay, which is hydro. Glycerol is a hydrophobic, which is a single, and this is hydrophilic. Okay, what do you mean by the hydrophobic and hydrophilic? So, hydrophilic and hydrophobic, that means hydrophilic head, that is glycerol, and hydrophobic tail. Okay, you can see here in the diagram. The philic, that means it attracts. And phobic, that means it neglects. Okay, it doesn't attract it. Okay, that's what. Monomer, these are the fatty acids, and polymers are the lipids. If we, whenever we talk about the monomer, it definitely has to be fatty acid. Whenever we talk about the polymer, it has to be lipid. Types of lipids, there are four types or main groups of the lipids include fatty acids, saturated and unsaturated. Saturated, that means with the single bond it is connected. Unsaturated, that means more than this. Okay, that is two bonds. Then glycerides, we have then non-glyceride lipids and complex lipids. This is just for your information. Next, biological importance of the lipids. They are the more palatable and storable to unlimited amount compared to the carbohydrates. See, the advantage over the carbohydrate. Unlimited as well as what? Storable and palatable. Then they have the high energy value, that is about 25% of the body which required the lipids. And they provide more of energy per gram than the carbohydrates and the proteins. But carbohydrates are preferable source of energy. Okay? Even though they provide much of energy, but preferable one is what? The carbohydrate. You have to remember this way. Supply the essential, the fatty acids. As I told you, fatty acids are monomers that cannot be synthesized by the body. Okay, in our body, we ourselves cannot synthesize this kind of fatty acids. Okay, so lipids gives us the monomers, that is fatty acid. Supply the body with the fat soluble vitamins, like fat soluble vitamins. Soluble ones is A, D, E, K. Vitamins we will see in tomorrow's class. Then they are the important constituent of the nervous system. Tissue fat is an essential constituent of cell membrane and nervous system. It is mainly phospholipid. So that lipid which is present in that cell membrane is in the form of phospholipid in nature that are not affected by the starvation. Okay. Now, what do you mean by the phospholipids? Phosphate at the head, which is hydrophilic, and at the tail, we have the fatty acid, which is hydrophobic. Okay, when there is a phosphate group, it is a phospholipid. Here we have biomedical importance. Okay, it is a bile salt, phosphoglandins, vitamins, hormones, then thermal and electrical insulator protection. It is a source of energy. So these are some of the importance of the phospholipid. Then the phosphoglandins. What do you mean by the phosphoglandins here? Almost it is present in all the tissues. It is a group of a compound. Okay, it is present in all the tissues. Then lipid sources, triglyceride found in plant and animal based food. Saturated fat mainly found in animal food origin, meat, eggs, milk, and excess lead to cardiovascular disease. As I told you, triglycerides, if they are in excess, you will face the heart diseases. Then unsaturated fat found in plant food origin, then seeds, nuts, plant oils, and the healthiest one. Cholesterol not present in the food of plant origin, liver, egg yolk, whole milk, butter and cheese. These are the sources where you find the cholesterol. Then, these are some few functions, okay, like bile acid, then cholesterol. Then we'll see the vitamin A, D, E, K. Then what fatty acids do, phospholipids, what they do, okay. Steroid hormones and triglycerides. So functions may we have bile acid like steroids that aid in fat digestion and nutrition absorption. If we talk about the fat soluble vitamins, they involved in variety of the functions including the blood clotting, wound healing, vision and calcium absorption. Then steroid hormones, these are the chemical messenger between the cell. They coordinate the various chemical reactions. Please take a screenshot. Yeah, at digestion of the fat, here with the help of this diagram, chewing and saliva begins digestion of the fats. Okay, once you have taken, then at the stomach, turns the triglycerides into the diglycerides and fatty acids. Okay, the simpler one. The triglyceride, which is actually not required by the body, it is an excess calories. Okay, so diglycerides here you can see the di, that means two bondes, tri means the three bonds in a blue lines. And the, finally, in the small intestine, it combines with the bile with the separated fats. Okay, now what do you mean by the bile? It is a green and yellowish brown fluid and it is stored in the liver. Okay, and which is required for the digestion of these lipids. Okay, so that is called as a bile. Then enzymes, just you have to have that information about the different names. That's it, not much important. Yeah, lipid metabolism. After this, what happens? This lipid metabolism, lipids in the blood of lipoprotein is excreted in the feces, then converted to brain and nerve tissue, oxidized for energy, then synthesized for the carbohydrates and proteins. Okay, so these are some of the metabolic activities that happened because of this lipids. Okay, then benefits. Yeah, this is important. Provide the texture, flavor, aroma to the food. Then phospholipids and cholesterol are structural material. Just now we have discussed this. Then help to absorb the fat soluble vitamins. Yes. Insulate, cushion and lubricate. That means it's protective in nature and provides lots of energy as compared to the carbohydrates and protein. Deficiency of fat in diet. Cause the deficiency of essential fatty acids, like lead to cessation of growth, that reduced growth. Okay, then cause the flaky skin, development of the itchy sore on the scalp, then phinoderma to the toad skin. It is such kind of skin diseases that just because of the reduced level of the fat diet. And then we have the excess obesity, lots of weight gain, then slow down digestion absorption of the food, and interferes in the absorption of the calcium. Okay, as I told you, if lots of fatty acids or the fats taken up, then the vitamin D level will, it may be lesser down, okay? And then you can have a loss of bone also. Okay, then causes ketosis, as I told you, causes ketosis. This ketosis is nothing but it is a low in glucose. Whereas our main source of energy in our body is carbohydrate. Okay, so these are the things happen. Then dietary sources, animal sources like dairy products, meat, butter, ghee, fish, pork, eggs, and vegetable sources. We have cooking oil, sunflower oil, mustard oil, groundnut oil, fats from the other vegetable sources. Okay, very easy. See here again, plant sources, nuts, olive, chocolates, avocados, sorry, food sources, in that we have animal, and this is a plant sources. Yeah, some of my questions over here. Name the types of foods. We have seen the types of foods. Those who know the answer, please raise your hand. Ma'am, please unmute them. Those who are raising their hand.
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah, the first question is name the types of food. The five types I have shown you in the pie chart.
Yes, miss.
Yes, please tell me.
Ma'am, the five types of food are fruits and vegetables first. Second, yes, is meat, fish and alternatives. Third, yes, is food containing fat and foods containing sugar. Mm-hmm. Fourth, milk and dairy products. Fifth, bread, other cereals and potatoes.
That's great. Thank you. Next one, give some example of protein sources. Anything from plant or animal, anything you can tell me. Protein sources. Two examples at least from plant and from animal. Very easy question. Yes, anyone? From where we get the proteins?
Students, tell the answer.
Raise your hand and unmute.
Ma'am.
Yeah.
Can I?
Shubhanshu. Shubhanshu. Anjali, will you please wait? We can ask Shubhanshu.
Okay, ma'am.
Yeah. Shubhanshu. Okay. Anybody else? Shubhanshu, am I audible? Yeah, please try. Okay. Other participants? Example of protein. Come on. Yeah, Anjali, you can tell.
Ma'am, we get protein from meat, fish, eggs. Mainly we get from this only, and also dairy products.
Yeah, good. Why do we need carbohydrates? As I emphasizing more on the carbohydrate. What is the requirement? Why it is much required? Why do we require?
Students, please raise your hand. Tell the answers.
In your own words, you can tell. Why carbohydrate will be required in our body? Anyone? What is the importance of carbohydrate? What it provides? As I told you, the carbohydrate is a rich source of energy, and around we get a 4 kilocalories of energy, right? From the per gram of, sorry, 4 kilogram of energy per gram of proteins we get it. But for carbohydrate lipids, we get 9 kilogram of energy. Even though the lipid and protein we get much of energy, but then also carbohydrate is easily available. It is a staple food. It is easily available for everyone, and it is a great source of energy. That's it. So you have to give any answer in that way. That is, a carbohydrate is a great source of energy, even though we are getting much of energy from other two components like lipid and proteins. Okay. Now, last one, give example of lipid rich food. That means fatty foods, fat rich. Yes, Anjali.
मैम एक बार आप क्वेश्चन एक्सप्लेन करेंगे मतलब उसमें क्या बोला है
विच वन फोर्थ वन ना गिव एग्जांपल ऑफ लिपिड रिच यानी सोर्सेस ऑफ लिपिड्स
मैम सोर्सेस मतलब डेयरी प्रोडक्ट्स हमें बहुत मिलते हैं
अच्छा
मीट्स फैटी मीट्स एंड फिश मिल्क
ओके yes, okay.
And means sunflower oil, mustard oil, groundnut oil.
These are the main prominent examples. Yeah. Yes.
Sakshi Verma, Tilak Nagar.
Anybody else?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes. Anybody having any doubt about today's class? Otherwise, I have done with. Yes, ma'am. I have done with.
Okay. No one have doubt.